morning.
How are you?
Amazing. How are you?
Good. Welcome to Calgary.
Thank you so much.
You've been a busy gal lately, eh?
It always seems to be busy, and then somehow you get busier and busier. But I'm working on a new record, so that's been really fun.
That's right. You even got a new song, which we added recently. So we'll talk about that shortly. You kind of split your time between Alberta and Nashville right now, right?
Yeah. And I mean, just for the sake of, obviously, I've got family here. I've got people I love here. We've got such an incredible industry, too, out here in Canada,
yes.
I have to say, with artists, festivals, fans. I mean, obviously, I love being from Alberta. I love being from Canada. But it's amazing that you can go out to Nashville and everyone you need is within 5 minutes of where you need to be. And it's just a complete music city. So it's been so fun to be out there and creating right now. And really excited to share a new album with you guys soon.
What age did you know that you wanted to really pursue music as a career path?
Oh, goodness. I remember probably being... Oh, I don't want to age myself, but it was like when Aaron Carter's first album came out. So maybe I was six.
Oh, wow. Way back
then. Maybe I was seven. And I remember like writing in my diary. At that point, it was like, you want to be a pop star. That was like the definition of it, right? And then that just turned into, you know, a love for music. And when I was 13, I started writing. And when I was 15, it was quite clear that country was what I wanted to be a part of, and I've just been chasing the dream ever since, so it's been pretty awesome.
You know, you've made a name for yourself in the country music community, nominated a two-time winner of the ACMA Female Artist of the Year Award. You were also nominated in categories for the CCMAs. In addition to those accolades, what's been the biggest highlight of your career so far?
Oh, what's been the biggest? I think just being able to travel and play festivals and meet fans.
No.
That's been pretty incredible. I remember when Don't Say You Love Me came out and receiving email after email after email from people across Canada saying how much my song meant to them and changed their life. And knowing that doing what I love, which is writing songs, playing songs, meeting people, knowing that that changes people's lives, that's pretty cool.
You know, is there anyone else you'd like to one day have the opportunity to work with in the future?
Ooh, there's a long list. I will say that. But I've always said that a duo with Brett Eldridge would be pretty cool.
That'd be sweet.
Yeah.
Real was your debut song in 2012. 6 years later, how have you grown both professionally and personally?
I think professionally. I know I'm a better writer now. I'll tell you that much. You know, I think I've just built a lot of confidence in myself, too, which has been a huge part of it. You do this every single day, and you just have a little bit more faith in yourself as you go along. There's always the highs and the lows, no matter what you do. But I've been really thankful to have, you know, everything come my way that has. And it's taught me a lot. So I think whatever you're doing, stick to it and make sure you're learning lessons every single day.
Excellent. We got Alee joining CJWE this morning. You brought your guitar. I'd love to hear a song.
Yeah, let's do it. I think it only makes sense to go back to this one. It did a lot for me. Thank you guys so much for supporting it. This is Moonshine.
Old sea line beating down sunsets right where I left it. I hadn't been back in years. There's your truck collecting its dust right where you left it. It's not the same without you here. And every day I would wait, I would pray you could stay here with me. No, I don't wanna let go. I hope you find your way home. He was like moonshine, he was strong as hell at that old dirt road. Sorry to say I didn't know it then, but now I see he was everything a man should be. He was constant, always say the same seasons. Came and went, but he never changed. Didn't know it then, but now I see he was everything to me. He was like moonshine. plagued by our old church seat. Kinda glad they left them. I can feel you here somehow. Goodbye seems too hard for me now that you left us. There's one more angel singing now. Oh, and every day I would wait, I would pray he could stay here with me. No, I don't wanna let go. I hope you find your way home. He was like moonshine, he was strong as hell. Like that old dirt road, sorry to tell, I didn't know it then, but now I see he was everything a man should be. He was constant, always stayed the same. Seasons came and went, but it never changed. He was strong as hell at that old dirt road. His story to tell, didn't know it then, but now I see he was everything I need. He was like moonshine. I didn't know it then, but now I see he was everything I need. He was like moonshine. He was strong as hell at that old dirt road. His story to tell.
CJWE sounded great.
Thank you.
So you've done a few music videos over the course of your career as well. What have those experiences been like for you?
So the first one, the first ever Don't Say You Love Me, was actually filmed in Edmonton at the Equine Center that I used to ride horses at. So that was kind of cool and neat throwback. And then you jumped to Only the Strong Survive, which was filmed in New York City, which was one of the craziest, wildest, most unbelievable experiences ever. And then just when you think you can't top that, we did Moonshine, which was actually done just outside of L.A. in Joshua Tree, which was actually the coolest. We had like a full set stylist, like the guy who's now styling like Ariana Grande's tour, some Beyonce stuff. It's pretty incredible that I got to work with some of the people that I did, and it's paved the way. So now the bar has been set. I don't know where it's going to be next, but I'm very excited.
Maybe right here in Calgary?
Who knows?
That'd be kind of cool.
That would be cool.
All right, the new song is called Don't Make Me Miss You. Tell us all about that song.
Oh, goodness. Well, I went into the right one day with Gavin Slate and Travis Wood, who actually, they work with James Barker Band, with the Reclaws, and absolutely love what they do, and we kind of started talking about, wouldn't it be great to write like a breakup song that a girl sings that doesn't sound whiny, but like helps you kind of realize that you're over someone, and all these little pieces that like listening to a song, driving, like taking it to someone's, taking a different way to not pass someone's house on the way home. All these little things that you don't have to do anymore because you're confident in who you are without having someone else. And this is one that I love playing live. It's been so great to hear the feedback from the fans so far, and it's kind of creating a new sound for me too.
Awesome.
So,
what are your fans saying about the song?
I've been hearing great feedback so far, so it's been fun. We've been having so much fun, like I said, making this new album, just kind of testing new things, seeing what the limits are, and just kind of playing with sounds, too.
Awesome.
So I'm excited about this one.
All right. What's coming up for you for the rest of the summer? Do you have a lot planned?
I've got some shows next weekend kind of in Alberta that I'm excited about, so we've got those, and then back to work on the records.
Awesome.
So,
can't wait to hear it.
Thank you.
Social media, where can people find you?
Gotta Be Alee. That's GottaBeAlee.
Always great to see you.
You too.
This is brand new Alee on CJWE. Good morning.
Tears plus time adds up. I don't need you anymore.